हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, इन लास्ट पीरियड वी हैव स्टार्टेड क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स। देयर आर फोर टाइप्स ऑफ क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स, आयोनिक, कोवेलेंट, मॉलिकुलर एंड मेटालिक सॉलिड। नाउ टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी कोवेलेंट नेटवर्क क्रिस्टल्स। सो कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ कोवेलेंट नेटवर्क क्रिस्टल्स। Before that, what is covalent network crystals? The solids in which covalent particles are atoms which are linked to each other by covalent bond to form continuous system or network of covalent bond having a large giant three-dimensional structure. They are also called a giant solids. They are hard and strong and directional in nature. Hence, atoms of these solids are held very strongly. So, and their geometry is definite in covalent solids. So, here are some characteristics of covalent network crystals. The constituent particles are atoms. The atoms in three-dimensional crystals are linked by a continuous system of covalent bond. A third one, as a result of rigid and strongly bonded structure, they are very hard. In fact, they are the hardest and the most incompressible of all the materials. They have high melting point and boiling points. The electrons are localized in covalent bonds and hence are not mobile. As a result, covalent solids are poor conductor of heat and electricity. So here some examples of covalent network crystals. First is diamond. Here network structure of diamond is given. In covalent crystalline solids, carbons which are linked to each other by a covalent bond. Here carbon atoms are sp3 hybridized to form a continuous structure of covalent bonds to give a giant three-dimensional structure. Here continuous network of carbon atoms is shown in this diagram. The carbon atoms are sp3 hybridized, which are arranged in a regular tetrahedron in which carbon atoms present at the center and at the corners of tetrahedron. So this is giant structure of diamond. Then here second structure of graphite is given, which is also example of covalent network crystals. Here it is also second allotrope of carbon. In graphite, each carbon atom is here sp2 hybridized. In diamond, there was sp3 hybridized carbon atom. Here, carbon atoms are sp2 hybridized to other 3sp2 hybridized carbon atom, and the fourth electron in unhybridized 2p z orbital is used for the formation of pi bond. This gives hexagonal two-dimensional ring of 6 carbon atoms, and in graphite the carbon atoms are held together by weak van der Waals forces of attraction. this make graphite soft and good lubricant. So this is the structure of graphite. Then third one is fullerene. It is also allotrope of carbon discovered by Buckminster Fuller. That is why the name is given fullerene. It is obtained by irradiating carbon to high power waves. An electric spark between graphite electrode produces soot, which is a good source of fullerene. An important fullerene is carbon 60, in which each carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. Here carbon atom is sp2 hybridized, which is linked to one another to give a hexagonal and pentagonal ring. There are 12 pentagonal and 20 hexagonal rings which are fused to one another to give a structure like soccer ball or a hollow sphere. Thank you.